I will be doing some video tutorials on assembly language programming, and I'll be using the Commodore 64, which, as many of you know, was the biggest selling computer of all time. And if you're here as a beginner learning assembly for the PC, the Apple, the ARM processor, or whatever, this may still be a good place to start, being that the C64 is a very minimal computer or operating system by today's standards, although at the time, 40 years ago, it was pretty state of the art. So the entire computer, there it is, the computer was built into the keyboard itself, and the beauty of it was, whereas earlier computers you might have to buy a monitor, the Commodore 64 worked with an ordinary TV set, NTSC in America or PAL in Europe. Today, 40 years later, there's kind of been a resurgence of interest in the C64 for, well, I mean, there's always been people kind of in the background plugging away at it, but more recently, they reintroduced the Commodore Mini. Which, let's see, it's about that big. You know, it's a fun little toy. It says $80 here. You get it for about $40 around town. And then about a year or so later, they introduced a full-size version, which is pretty close to the size of the original C64. Now, beauty of the modern day one is you can use it with a modern peripheral. It has HDMI output, so you can plug it into any ordinary HDMI monitor or your widescreen TV or whatever. Although it'll be great big pixels on a high resolution screen, but whatever. And you can also plug in some modern day peripherals such as an external keyboard or other things. Now, today, if you wanted to play around with the Commodore 64, you don't have to buy one, although they are pretty cheap. You can actually get an emulator called Vice, and it runs on a variety of different platforms there. Yeah, and that will perfectly emulate a Commodore 64 on whatever computer you have. You can just go and download that, and it looks like that. And that's exactly what you would see when you start up a C64. You can also go full screen like that, you know. And of course, I remember in the old days, you know, a friend of mine had one of these and let me play around with it. And you'd sit down and you'd try and do things with it. And, you know, there you go, you get an error, you know, or try and run a program or something. Error, error. So you couldn't do much with it without an instruction book, you know. But fortunately, today, whereas most people are accustomed to throwing money at it when they want to learn some programming language or whatever, today you don't have to. Let me see, I'm going to exit out of this by hitting Alt Escape. There, I have exited out of my C64. So yeah, you just download Vice, and let me see here. Folder up, let me find it here now. The C64 Vice. There it is. And if I go to bin, it's down here in the X's here. Vice comes with the C64, the Commodore 128, the PET, a number of different emulators, but there's your C64 right there. You know, so you can just launch that and play around with it. So if you're here looking to learn assembly on the Commodore 64, you can skip ahead a lesson. The next lesson will cover a little bit of basic, just a quick rundown. Most computer books programming books for the Commodore 64 assembly assumed you were already fluent with BASIC. I won't make that assumption. I will show you whatever commands in BASIC and how they work, and then show you the equivalent in assembly. Okay, so like I said, if you want to skip straight to the assembly, just go straight to lesson 3.